that's really going into the kingdom, all right? But let me go back to the point in Isaiah, the 42nd chapter. So it's the book of Isaiah 42 and 8. It says, I am the Lord, Yahweh. That is my name, and my glory will I not give to another, right? That's why did he have to make it known his name, right? Because he was established he was basically making it easy for his power to be that identified, right? Because if people say that God's name is just God, or he doesn't have a name, basically they're not separating him from all these different idols, right? For example, you have Islam, where they basically say that God has 99 names. That's nonsense, all right? The Heavenly Father has one name, right? And one spirit, right? And the reason why he has one name and one spirit is so you can be identified and he can establish his power, okay? So it says, Isaiah 42 and 8, so it says, I am the Lord, that is my name, and my glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images, right? And anything outside of the Bible, any God outside of the Bible is basically is an idol, right? It's a falsehood, all right? So verse 9, it says, behold, the former things are come to pass, and new things do I declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you of them, all right? So basically, I went into the former things, but now let's go into the new things, all right? Because right now, what you're seeing on play out on earth right now is the time of the end, all right? Because it's been prophesied in the Bible. That's why, and I say this every week, the year 2020 is a crazy year, because we're at the end of this world, man. And it don't mean the world's gonna blow up or nothing. It means we're in a transition of kingdoms, all right? This is like new. When you look into world history, where multiple different kingdoms rise up and it be taken down, right? Or have risen up and been taken down. Let me read that first, actually. Don't. lucky, man. Oh, I can't even remember. Basically, the Heavenly Father sets up one and then takes down another. Right? So let me, where was I going with this? Right? So basically, there's new prophecies that's coming to pass. Right? So it's the book of Revelation, the 14th chapter. No. Revelation 11. Revelation 11 and 14, it reads, it says, the second woe is past, and behold, the third woe cometh quickly. All right? Right now, we're in the midst of basically three key prophecies that need to take place. All right? The first one being the RFID chip. All right? The second one being World War III, and the third being the return, or basically the day of the Lord. All right? And basically, in the midst of the first one that I mentioned, being the RFID chip, that's basically going to bring about the time of Jacob's trouble, the hour of temptation. That's basically going to come upon the whole world, right? So anyway, so it's Revelations 11 and 14. It says, the second woe is past, and behold, the third woe cometh quickly. Right? So, like I said, you've got three key prophecies that need to take place in accordance with the Bible. Alright? And we're in the midst of the first one being the RFID chip coming to pass. But also, we have bubbling in the background is World War III. Right? Now, a lot of people tend to forget because 2020 has been such a tumultuous year that a lot of people forgot what set the precedent, all right? Being the assassination of Soleimani, all right? A general over in the land of Iran, okay? But now what you've recently had happen as well is you had a nuclear scientist be assassinated over in the land of Iran as well, all right? And why is that happening? Because it's setting the stage, and they're saying that basically it was the Israelis that did it, all right? Because they're setting the stage for World War III. So let me read this prophecy in the Bible. This is the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah 49 and 20, it says, therefore hear the counsel of the Lord Yahweh, that he have taken against Edom, and his purposes, that he have purposed against the inhabitants of Teman, right? To use Edom, right? When the Bible speaks to people, talks about these biblical nationalities, those people never passed away. When it's talking about Edom, it's talking about the so-called white man, all right? Or the so-called white race, right? So I'll read it again. So it says, therefore, hear the counsel of the Lord that he have taken against Edom, right? And his purpose that he have purposed against the inhabitants of Teman, right? Teman really is talking about the Germans, right? Because they're the wise men over the Edomites, right? They're the ones that basically set forth all forms of technology, right? All you gotta do is read the book of Ezekiel, the 28th chapter, and it tells you about the wise men of Teman, right? Because really, when you deal with nuclear technology, the reason why it's present on this earth is dealing with the scientists that came out of Nazi Germany, right? Half of them were taken by the Americans, half of them were taken by the Russians, all right? And that's what led into, that spilled into the Cold War, basically, all right? So anyway, reading it again from the top, it says, therefore hear the counsel of the Lord Yahweh, they have taken against Edom, and his purposes they have purposed against the inhabitants of Teman. Surely the least of the flock shall draw them out, right? So who's the least of the flock that shall draw them out? They're talking about the Israelis, right? Why are they the least of the flock? Why are they known as the least of the flock? Because they're that small, what they call the state of Israel, basically has great power, all right? And they're the furthest away. They're the most far removed. They're over in the land of what you call today, so-called Arabia, all right? And that land over there, that landmass that they're at over there, they hold a lot of pulling power, all right? And that's for this prophecy to be fulfilled. So it says, surely the least of the flock shall draw them out. Surely he shall make their habitation desolate with them, right? The earth, so it's saying that the least of the flock. So they're basically going to be the main catalyst in this World War III, right? That it tells you about in the book of Revelation, the 11th chapter. Okay? They're going to be the primary catalyst for World War III. And that's why you see what's happened recently, what happened at the start of the year with General Soleimani over in the land of Iran being assassinated, and more recently, the nuclear scientists over in the land of Iran being assassinated. Those are all key factors that are going to play a part in World War III, all right? And World War III ain't going to be like, it's going to be battled on many fronts, but ultimately, World War III is going to be done by a firefight by America and Russia and their proxies, right? And that's on its way very soon. So it's the book of Isaiah 9 and 5, and it reads, for every battle of the warrior is with confused noise,